I married Isis on the 5th day of May, but I could not hold on to her very long. So I cut off my hair and I rode straight away for some wild unknown country where I could not go wrong. I came to a high place of darkness and light. The dividing line ran through the center of town. Hitched up my pony to a post on the right. Went into the laundry to wash my clothes down. Well, a man in the corner, he approached me for a match. I knew right away he was not ordinary. He said, "Are you looking for something easy to catch?" I said, "I got no money." He said, "That ain't necessary." We set off that night for the cold in the north. He gave my blanket and he gave me his word. I said, "Where are we going?" He said, "We're back by the fourth." I said, "Well, that's the best news I've ever heard." I was thinking about turquoise, I was thinking about gold, I was thinking about diamonds and the world's biggest necklace. I was thinking riding through the devilish cold. I was thinking about Isis, how she thought I was so reckless. She told me that one day we would meet up again. Things would be different the next time we wed. If I could only hang on and just be her friend. I still can't remember all the best things she said. We came to the pyramids all embedded in ice. He said, "There's a body I'm trying to find. If I can carry it out, it'll bring a good price." It was then that I knew what he had on his mind. The wind was howling and the snow was outrageous. We chopped through the night and we chopped through the dawn. When he died, I was hoping that it wasn't contagious, but I made up my mind that I had to go on. I broke into the tomb, but the casket was empty. There was no jewels, no nothing. I fell, I've been half. My partner was being friendly, just being tricky. Took up his offer, well, I must have been mad. I picked up his body and I dragged him inside. I threw him down in the hole and I pulled back the cover. I said a quick prayer and I felt satisfied. Then I rode back to find Isis just to tell her I love her. Used to rise, blinded by sleep and in need of a bed. Came in from the east with the sun in my eyes. I cursed her one time, then I rode on ahead. She said, "Where you been?" I said, "No place special." She said, "You're looking different." I said, "Well, I guess." She said, "You've been gone." I said, "That's only natural." She said, "You're gonna stay." Said, "If you want me to, yes." Well, Isis, oh Isis, you're a mystical child. What drives me to you is what drives me insane. I still can't remember the way that you cried on the 5th day of May.